grew up in Massillon, Ohio. I grew up listening to mostly rock, and I played in a lot of rock bands and pop bands, but one of the earliest bands I played in when I was like 12 was, we played weddings and, you know, bars, whatever, and some of what they played was country music. So then I was playing George Jones and different things, stuff that I had never heard before, but I just learned it and played it. So when I was 20, I guess, a friend of mine was going to go to Nashville because he was a songwriter and he wanted to check out what Nashville was like. And I had been talking about maybe going to LA or New York or Nashville. And so when he said he was going, I thought, man, I'd love to go to Nashville. So I said, I'll go with you. And we both went there for a couple weeks. And my friend ended up moving back to Ohio, you know, for a little bit and gathering. And I really liked it. And so I stayed, you know, I just stayed there and tried to go hear as many bands as possible, just see what kind of music there was. I had actually saved up some money from gigging in Ohio, near Cleveland mostly, who I played, and I saved up about enough money to live for 6 months in a little apartment, furnished apartment. I had no furniture, I didn't know one person there, and eventually I met a guitar player that had toured with different people, and he's like, well, it feels really good when you play, you know, it sounds... You know, he knew I was like 20 at the time, and he knew I was like, man, I'm looking for any kind of work or gig, and he recommended me for Barbara Mandrell when she was looking for a drummer. So I got to audition for her, and, you know, I knew a few of her tunes, but I knew she was like a pretty big deal because I knew she had a TV show and everything, so... I auditioned for her, and that was really my first road gig. You know, when I got that gig, I did that for 5 years. So that kind of got me started, and, you know, first time traveling and doing all that. And she treated me great. She was really nice, and I was young, and I didn't have any experience traveling or touring or any of that. But I never tried to act like I did. I just asked a lot of questions, and everybody was really helpful. You know. They were nice. So. Then I auditioned for Trisha Yearwood's gig. She was looking for a drummer. And I had heard a lot of her music and really liked her music, and she was kind of doing more touring, whereas Barbara would do some sit-down dates maybe in Vegas a couple weeks at a time. And, you know, I was still pretty young and just kind of wanted to experience that, going on the road, playing, open up for other artists sometimes, or doing our own theater gigs, and really liked her singing, and so I tried out for her band and got that gig, you know, and then I did that for 6 or 7 years with her. It sounds like, wow, you go to Nashville, you audition, get a gig, and then you audition, get another one. It was, you know, if you know every detail of all those things, it wasn't so smooth and stress-free, you know. Actually, when I auditioned for Barbara's gig, I didn't get the gig at first. It was between me and another guy, and they called and said, it's down to you and one other guy. And they called and said, we're going to go with this other guy, but if it doesn't work out, we'll call you back. And as it turned out, the first guy, it wasn't working out with him, and they wanted to make a change, you know. It was like, we should have... They were a little worried because I was like 20 when I auditioned, you know, and they're like, I don't know, you know. But so they called me and to tell me, you know, if you still want the gig, you can have it. But the apartment, because I was out of money, I moved out of that apartment. I found a room in some other guy's house where I could rent, you know, a couple weeks at a time. So they spent like 3 days trying to find a phone number. It was before cell phones, everything. finally, they called my mom's house in Ohio and got a hold of her, you know, and I called him back and he was like, you know, if you still want the gig, I was like, oh yeah, I was completely broke, you know, so it's been great. I mean, I wouldn't trade any of it, but
there's some dues to pay.
Yeah, there's definitely some dues to pay. I got off the road after touring with Trisha for about 5 years. I was starting to get called to do more session work, but then I heard Peter Frampton was looking for a drummer. So I auditioned for him, and I thought, well, if I can do that, you know, it'd be such a fun thing to do. So I ended up touring with him for 4 years. And then I re-left the road again to really settle in with sessions because I had two kids and my wife at home. I really wanted to be home a little more. He was going out for maybe a month or two straight without even getting back for a day, or you know, so it was a little much to try to raise a family at the time. And then this Tim's gig came up, and he mainly did weekends, and my kids were a little older, and it was like, go out for 3 or 4 days, you come home for 3 or 4 days. I'm really fortunate to have this gig to go out and play live, and it's really fun. And then I can also record some during the week when I'm home and see my family. So. Vic Firth for as long as I can remember, really. I've been an endorser for, well, since the Barbara Mandrell days, you know, in 91, I guess I got that gig, so it's been a long time. Over the years, you know, I've had other drummers I know say, man, I've been using these, I like this grip or something about them, and I'll try another brand, and, you know, at the drum shop, they'll kind of show me, and I'll like, well, let me see some, and I'll roll them a little bit, and I noticed some wobbling, and I was like, these just don't feel right. It's really not up to the standards of Vic's sticks, which always roll straight. I don't even roll them anymore because I just know, you know, and I can feel that without rolling. If you have, you know, it just doesn't play the same. So I always get the same reaction on the rye, that they just feel great to me.